السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب زدني علما. اللهم فقهنا في الدين. آمين يا رب العالمين. Lesson number 23. Types of verbs or فعل based on time or tense. Verb فعل is doing or happening of any action and it has tense as well. For example, خرج, he left. يخرج, he leaves or he will leave. If there is name of verb but there is no tense, then that is called root form or مصدر. For example, استغفر means he sought forgiveness. This is a verb. يستغفر means he seeks forgiveness or he will seek forgiveness. This is also a verb. Whereas استغفار means to seek refuge or forgiveness, and this is the مصدر or the root form. Scholars of grammar, صرف and نحو have divided verb or فعل into different types according to different categories. For example, in terms of tense and time, verb has three types. In terms of weak letters or vowels, حروف علة, verb has two types. In terms of presence of doer or فاعل, verb has two types. In terms of need of object or مفعول, the verb has two types. And in terms of number of letters or حروف, the verb has two types. Let us look at these different types of verbs. Types of verbs or فعل. Number 1, types of verbs in terms of tense or time. Number 2, types of verbs in terms of weak letters, vowels or حروف علة. Number 3, types of verbs in terms of presence of doer or فاعل. And number 4, types of verbs in terms of need of object or مفعول. And number 5, types of verbs in terms of number of letters or حروف. The types of verbs in terms of tense or time are further divided into three: past, madi, present, mudare, and affirmative or negative, amro, nahi. Today we will study types of verbs or فعل in terms of time or tense. In terms of time or tense, the فعل or verb is of three types. Number 1, past, madi. Number 2, present, mudare. And number 3, affirmative or negative, amro, nahi. Before explaining these three, keep in mind that as these three, madi, mudare and amro, nahi, are types of verbs, فعل, in respect to time and tense, so the term verb or فعل can be written along with them. For example, فعل madi, فعل مضارع and فعل أمر نهي. As you know that فعل is one of the three types of كلمة, اسم فعل and حرف. فعل or verb is that كلمة which shows doing or happening of any action with respect to three tenses. For example, ذهب, he went, is فعل ماضي. يدخل, he enters, is فعل مضارع. And سوف تعلمون, you all will know, is also فعل مضارع. This is because in Arabic, مضارع is used for both present and future tense. However, its meaning of present and future is taken according to the sentence. In the stated examples, we translated يدخل as present tense. Whereas, سوف تعلمون is taken as in future tense because of سوف. Now, let us study the three types of verbs or فعل. Number 1, فعل ماضي. Number 2, فعل مضارع. And number 3, فعل أمر نهي, also known as حاضر معروف, one by one. Past tense verb or فعل ماضي. This is the فعل or verb which indicates some action or work done in the past tense. For example, كتب زيدٌ. كتب زيدٌ means زيد wrote in past tense. Let us memorize the conjugation of فعل ماضي. فعل ماضي کی گردان. So that whenever there is a فعل on pattern or measure of this conjugation, we can identify it. Whether it is singular, dual, tathniya or plural, masculine or feminine, first person, second person or third person. Before memorizing conjugation of fi'l madi, let us understand some points. When a verb is on the pattern of fa'ala, then it would be the third person singular masculine. For example, on the pattern of fa'ala is nasara, he helped. It indicates the third person singular masculine. He means singular masculine that is not present, so will be called third person. We already learned that in past tense, three patterns of fi'l madi, fa'ala, fa'ila and fa'ula are made by changing the movement or harakat on the ayn kalima. This is the reason sami'a and karuma also indicate the third person masculine singular. For third person dual masculine, that is tathniya mudhakkar ghaib, fa'ala is used. For example, nasara means those two men helped. The alif added to fa'ala shows the pronoun here for the second person. For example, nasara means those two men help. The alif added to nasara root word shows the pronoun for the dual. For the third person masculine plural, jama' mudhakkar ghaib, fa'alu is used. Nasaru is on this pattern, which means all those men helped. So waw alif added after the root word nasara is the pronoun for the third person plural. In the past tense, fi'l madi, fa'ala is used for third person singular masculine, wahid mudhakkar ghaib. In this, only the root words fa, ayn and lam are used. There is no visible indication except root word, that is, there is no additional letter except the root word. Whereas, in the third person dual tathniya masculine, it was nasara, means two men helped. The pronoun for the third person dual tathniya masculine is alif, which is in addition to the root words noon, swad and ra. The pronoun waw is used for the third person plural masculine. For example, nasaru is they all men helped. Now let us learn about feminine. For third person feminine singular, the pronoun ta sakina is used. For example, nasarat, she helped. For third person feminine dual tathniya, the pronoun alif is used. For example, nasarta, two females helped. For third person plural feminine, pronoun of noon maftuha or noon with fatha or zabar is used. For example, nasarna. Now let us study the second person or the hadir. The person who is spoken to is called present, is called the second person or the hadir. In Urdu, word tum is used and in English, you is used. For the second person masculine singular pronoun, ta maftuha, that is ta with zabar or fatha, is used. For example, nasarta means you, for the singular masculine, helped. For the second person masculine dual tathniya, the pronoun tuma is used. For example, nasartuma means you two men helped. For second person masculine plural, pronoun tum is used. For example, nasartum means you all men helped. Pronoun for second person feminine singular is ta maksura, that is ta with zair or kasra. For example, nasarti means you singular feminine helped. For the second person feminine dual pronoun, tuma is used. For example, nasartuma means you two females helped. The pronoun for second person feminine plural is tunna. For example, nasartunna means you all females helped. Talking about oneself is called mutakallam, the first person, masculine, singular. It can be both masculine and feminine. For first person singular masculine pronoun, ta madhumuma or the with page or dhamma is used. For example, nasartu means I, singular, masculine or feminine, help. Similarly, for first person dual and plural, masculine or feminine, the pronoun na is used. For example, nasarna means we two or all masculine helped, or we two or all feminine helped. Let's look at the past tense conjugation. Fel madi hi gardan. The singular third person masculine is fa'ala. The dual third person masculine is fa'ala. The plural third person masculine is fa'alu. Whereas the singular third person feminine is fa'alat. Dual third person feminine is fa'alata. Plural third person feminine is fa'alna. Singular second person masculine is fa'alta. Dual second person masculine is fa'altuma. And the plural second person masculine is fa'altum. The singular second person feminine is fa'alti. The dual second person feminine is fa'altuma. And the plural second person feminine is fa'altunna. The singular first person masculine and feminine is fa'altu. The dual and the plural for the first person masculine and feminine is fa'alna. According to the time period or tense, the second type of verb is mudare, present tense. The present tense shows any action in both the present and future. Example, yansuru, meaning he helps or he will help. By adding any of the signs of present tense yatan at the beginning of the past tense verb, it can be changed to the present tense. Example, from nasara, yansuru is made. It's a third person singular masculine. It is made on the pattern of yaf'ulu. Come, let's learn the conjugation of the present tense. The present tense conjugation, fi'l mudari ki gardan. The singular third person masculine is yaf'alu. The dual third person masculine is yaf'alani. The plural third person masculine is yaf'aluna. The singular third person feminine is taf'alu. Dual third person feminine is taf'alani. The plural third person feminine is yaf'alna. The singular second person masculine is taf'alu. The dual second person masculine is taf'alani. The plural second person masculine is taf'aluna. The singular second person feminine is taf'alina. The dual second person feminine is taf'alani. The plural second person feminine is taf'alna. The singular first person masculine and feminine is af'alu. The dual first person masculine and feminine is naf'alu. And the plural for first person masculine and feminine is naf'alu. We have to memorize these conjugations for both past tense and present tense. So according to the tense or time period, the third type of verb is amr or nahi. The negative and the affirmative and the negative commands. Amr or nahi is that verb in which if an order is given to do something, it is called fi'le amr or affirmative command. Example, unsur, you help. And if an order is given not to do a thing, then it is called fi'l nahi, negative command. Example, la tushrik, don't do shirk or don't assign partners. Alhamdulillah, we have completed the three types of verbs based on tenses: the past tense, fi'l madi, present tense فعل مضارع and the positive affirmative and negative commands فعل أمر and نهي today. Inshallah, we will study about the types of verbs based on the vowels in the next class. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.